we understand that one of the most important aspects of studying Jewish history and thinking as a Jew is to understand what's going on below the surface. And we understand also that whenever there's problems that come against the Jewish people from outside, they're just the symptoms. The real cause is always something deeper. And the Talmud, when discussing why the first temple was destroyed, says it was destroyed because the Jews violated certain basic commandments. We misbehaved, and God took Jerusalem and the temple away from us. In the second temple, the rabbi said the reason why it was destroyed was because of sinat chinam, of causeless hatred of one Jew for another Jew, of the infighting, as we've seen previously. And that's really what is the factor, the key factor. One lesson you see that's so important, and again, it's so applicable to what we see in the Jewish world today, is that God has little or no patience for the Jewish people for fighting amongst ourselves. It's like a parent sort of watching children fight. Anyone who's a parent appreciates that, you know, relationships with kids can be difficult. Your kids at teenage years, they can be disrespectful. They can fight with you and argue with you. But any parent who's a good parent, who loves his children or her children, would much rather see a child fight with the parent than children fighting amongst each other. Nothing gives a parent more pain than two kids, two of their own children, beating each other up, calling each other names. And we see that that is a very important lesson and pattern from Jewish history. God just doesn't have patience for us fighting amongst each other. If we're going to kill each other, he says, I'd rather not watch you guys do it. I'm going to send the non-Jews to do it. I'll send an enemy like the Romans. And again, we see, as so many of the lessons of the past are relevant until today, that exactly in the modern state of Israel today, the exact same thing has happened. There's a scary parallel between infighting, debates in Israel that sometimes become violent, religious and secular, left and right wing, which actually lead to protests and police coming out and Jews beating up other Jews. You can almost tie, without exception, external threats, terrorism, violence, wars and uprisings coming from without to what's going on within the Jewish world. And the lesson we need to learn from that whole story is how important it is that we don't always have to all agree as Jews, but we have to remember we're one giant family. And there's so many people in this world who are out to get us. Why are we fighting amongst each other? Respect for each other, unity, is one of the great lessons we learned from the story. And if we don't have that, it ends in disaster, as it happened to the Jews 2,000 years ago with the destruction of the Second Temple and the expulsion from Israel.